Anita. You look tired, Steve. Is your husband not looking after you?
I'm trying.
I can look after myself.
Well, I'm coming your way.
Eve is the blonde. She was murdered during Anita Sido's wedding.
Good girl, you know. Lively, funny. The client took a shine to her, you know. She'd make the most of it. She'd smile, wear a skirt a little higher.
Was she friendly with Kenny?
They got on. But she got on with everyone. So did Raymond Kenyon, really. And now we could get life for killing her.
Yeah, but why would he want to kill her?
I haven't got a clue. Can't believe it myself.
So there's nothing going on between them? But sure.
I don't know. All right, Gina.
Hi.
How are you feeling today? Any better?
I'm okay.
That's unlike you. Was she working at the wedding too?
Everyone was working at the wedding. Biggest event in the hotel's history.
I tell you what, mate. If we do take this on, we've got to be sure that, one, we believe Selena Kenyon, and two, that we can do it. Because this fella, Alex Sido, is heavy duty, and I mean Eastern Bloc heavy duty.
Yeah, I know.
And if he is dangerous, and if he is responsible, and if he is the money, then I don't see how we can get close enough to prove it. Hmm. I mean, what if we get caught?
Well, we can say goodbye to our bottles.
Yeah, well, I'm rather attached to mine. They've got names.
Look, I'll go and see him.
Alex Sido?
No, our so-called killer, Raymond Kenyon.
How much are they paying you?
How much is 15 years of your life worth? Hey? Think about it, Raymond. The Salida would be gone. No kids, no history. How much is that worth? You haven't thought this through, have you, Raymond?
I don't know what you're on about.
Who's paying? Is it Alex Sido? I mean, he owns the hotel where it happened. It was his daughter's wedding. Who are you covering for? One of the guests? Who's paying you?
What for?
For the rest of your life.
What's going on? Who is he?
I'm here to help you, Raymond.
Yeah, we don't need any help, you know that. Are you trying to get me killed, love?
I just want you with me. I want you in my bed every night. I want to make babies. Don't look away. Isn't that important anymore?
Of course it's important.
Stop it.
Ask him to leave. Who is he?
He's a private detective and I'm paying him with the money you gave me. Your first installment.
Oh, Jesus Christ, I'm missing.
No, sorry, please, no. Wait, last thing we need is someone poking around. 5 years? was set for life. 5 years in exchange for 45 without a care in the world.
That's Raymond Kenyon. In the picture is the client, Selena Kenyon, the wife.
She's nice.
He was working in and out of the kitchen at the Central Hotel 3 weeks ago. He supposedly killed a waitress, Ava Krakowicz.
Polish girl, one on the left.
He supposedly killed her?
Yeah, well, he's the body, the mug. You know, he's doing time for someone else's crime.
Who?
Well, that's the mission, isn't it? Should we choose to accept it?
That's the job.
How was she killed?
Bang to the head. Well, that's what we're told. And that was from Selena Kenyon.
And the evidence against him?
He confessed.
And that's it?
Well, that's all we know, but that's what we're going to find out.
And what we do know is that he's only confessed to manslaughter, and he's already got a top QC lined up to defend him.
Yeah? Who's paying for that?
Pro bono, allegedly. Ava was murdered in room 402 of the hotel during Anita Sedor's wedding. This is the father of the bride, Alex Sedor, owner of the Central Hotel. His daughter, Anita, married this fella. The dashing hotel manager, Martin Downing, Sagittarius.
Same as me. I'm a Sagittarius.
So this is our guy, yeah? Alex Sedor.
Well, let me put it this way. Sedor owns the hotel. They were his guests at his daughter's wedding.
Poor thing.
Now, to put a body up takes money, power, and balls. So it's got to be Alex Sedor. But who's he protecting? Himself or, one of the guests?
Selena Kenyon, I'm Robert.
Would you like a cup of tea?
Milk and two sugars, please.
I don't care what his wife says. From what I've heard, it's more than a bang to the head. Much more.
Might want.
Near many object in an hotel room, and apparently she was hit with it.
You sure?
That's what they're saying.
Well, I need pictures.
No.
And a copy of the postmortem.
No chance.
Raymond Kenyon didn't kill the waitress. He was paid to go to prison. Yeah, it's true.
Well, then he must be earning a fortune, because he's going down for life.
Well, look, I need to have a look at these files.
Not a chance.
What about pictures of the pictures? Yeah.
So, how long have you been married?
6 years.
Happy?
Yeah. Apart from the 6 months he was locked up.
In jail?
Yeah. I had a persistent and unwanted admirer at work. Ray hit him, he beat him up quite badly.
Well, and he got sent down for it?
Second offence. Bastard judge. He's not been in trouble since, though. Hello?
I don't want you to visit me anymore. I've let you down.
What's the matter, Raymond?
I was sleeping with Ava and she wanted me to leave you.
You're lying. You're making it up.
Selena, I'm not like you. It's all come out of court.
It's the truth. She's going to tell you how I hit her.
You're lying.
I killed her, said it, I really did. I just want you to know I never loved her. I love you and I always will. I'm so sorry.
So have you still got a job? Do you believe him?
Does Selena believe him?
I think she does.
He's already been locked up for hitting people.
Says who?
Selena.
Now, what did you tell me? How many times have I got to tell you how important it is?
If he really is guilty of the murder, where did she get the money to pay us with from? And why is a QC bothering with a low lie? Yeah.
Hands up if you think he made the phone call to shut Selena up.
So we have the job.
We just don't have a client.
She'll change her mind.
Will she? How do you know,
Jack? Yeah, okay. Vincent, I'm to tell you your pictures are ready.
Right. Sorry, boss. You've got to start using your loaf.
Yes, boss.
Don't tell me I'm still innocent.
I just want to see some dirty pictures. You're a favour. Taken by the forensic pathologist. Have a look. And my friend reckons you got no chance with a manslaughter claim. He also reckons these pictures got life written all over them. With or without a dancing QC.
Look, I
going to the full floor. I'll start at one end of the corridor, you start at the other.
Where are you?
In the office.
I've got a geezer on me daily. I'm next to the Val arcade. I'll meet you there in 5 minutes, yeah?
Right, okay, bye.
Hey. Look, they said that you were going to show me the central hotel where you're doing things. So should I just watch or drop to help you?
I don't really care one way or the other.
Well, it's going to be a really long morning if we carry on like this. I'm Beth.
Gina, look, the bathroom's the most important. Leave no hairs in the bath, toilets flushed, paper folded, all surfaces clean. Have a go and I'll take a look.
Yeah, okay. That wasn't so difficult, was it?
Drive around the world until you get here.
Blue jacket.
Put the message in the box, put the box into the car. Yeah, bye, bye.
Got him. Disappear when you like. I'll stay with him.
Yeah.
Everything all right, boss?
Beth,
is she at
the hotel?
Yeah, she started this morning.
Jill, get on the phone and tell her to take it easy. In fact, tell her to keep her mouth shut. I don't want no questions. Tell her not to make herself busy. Not yet.
What's happened?
Yeah?
Vincent, it's Chris. That list you wanted. I have a price for you.
It's 500.
No.
I'm not moving.
Well, you're going to have to.
Listen, for 750, you can have that wedding list and a special name of someone who attended the event, but for whatever reason preferred his attendance to go unnoticed. And listen, Vince.
I'll take the risk for you. I expect a fair price.
I'll give you 400 quid for the list and a name.
Done.
I'll send someone over to collect it.
want you to pretend to steal my car. Don't break the windows, the doors are open. Once you've got it, I want you to go through it with a fine-tooth comb. Make sure there's nothing moody on it.
Gotcha.
Then I want you to go over to Central Hotel, collect an envelope from Chris the concierge.
Well, and that's for Chris, yeah?
Yeah, don't lose it.
I could collect the envelope while Robert steals your car.
No, I want you to stay here.
Again?
Listen, Jill, there are certain jobs you have to do exactly as you're told, exactly, and this is one of them. And that goes for you too. Right, make sure you're not being followed. I want you in and out as quick as you can. Do you understand?
Yes.
You?
Yes.
Good. Nobody moves a muscle unless I say so.
Gotcha.
Go.
Go on.
Go on, boss.
Jill, I'm sorry, babe.
Has something happened?
Yeah, I can't get my head around it. I'll tell you all about it once I've done it.
The people they tip are the concierge, barman and the hookers.
Honestly?
Honestly.
Afternoon, Gina, working hard?
As always, Mr. Downing.
And who's this? A new face?
Yeah. Beth, I started this morning.
Martin Downing, I hope you'll have a happy stay with us, Beth.
Oh, thank you.
A decent sort, aren't we, Gina?
Fantastic.
So, have a good day.
Yeah, you too. It was nice. Take it from your silence, you disagree. Have a go at this one on your own, yeah? Hey, didn't you just get married? I'll be next door.
Vince! Bloke following you. He's one of us, only not as good. He's a PI with QT Investigations, king of the corporates. Can you believe he made a call from a phone box? Of course, I made the last number reader.
Very good.
Right, thank you.
Raymond Kenny instead.
You're joking. When?
This morning. Some nutter cut his throat right in front of me.
You all right?
Not yet, no.
Have you told Selenia?
No, I haven't.
What does she know?
She will, I'll go and see her later. Go and see her later. Chance for a cup of tea.
Do you think he killed Ava?
No. No, I don't. Not for 1 minute. And I mean that. Wait. You didn't do this. We didn't do this. This was always going to happen from the minute Raymond allowed himself to be the body. This was always going to happen there. That's not your fault, and don't you dare let yourself think it was. I put your money.
Why?
Because it's yours.
Are you giving up?
Well, there's 5 grand there. You're going to need it.
I don't want it. It's their money. I want you to have it. I want you to find out who's doing this. Will you do that?
Well, I'll try, yeah. I'll do my best, yeah.
Thank you.
I've been reading your CV. You've done civil service.
Yeah, reception work. I'm a hotel's dream.
Well, we've got a very special lunch tomorrow, and I was wondering if you would like to wait on.
What, here?
Downstairs, yeah.
Why me?
A, because you can do it, and B, because you're very attractive, and our table will be exclusively male. And we want to impress in every way we can. It's not exactly PC, but it's still the way of business. Do you mind?
Will there be other servers?
Beth, it's a business lunch, not a stag night. I guarantee you will not be pestered. Although one or two might stare a little. Deal?
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, nice hotel, that. Chris, the concierge, is a bit creepy, don't he? A bit oily.
He's a concierge.
What's on the envelope?
Secret dump.
It's the guest list to Alex Seedorf's daughter's wedding. That's a bonus night. Philip Costello, MP.
Never heard of him.
Why am I not surprised about that?
He's quite high up, isn't he? Front bench.
Philip Charles Costello, Junior Minister, Home Office.
Interesting.
Been an MP for 11 years, married to Juliet.
A very good friends with Eastern European businessman, Alex Seedorf, yeah?
Yeah, that's right.
What, you think he's gay?
Yeah, Robert, Juliet's got a moustache and a beard.
Gillian, all the gay MPs are married.
Well, Seedorf could be selling him anything from tin cups to tanks, or they could just be good friends.
Or lovers.
Robert, shut up.
How'd they get a key then, the landlord?
Well, the agent. It's a cake in the fridge if you want it.
What kind of cake?
Stale cake.
Cheers, boss.
Seedorf.
Why?
Oh, I'll introduce myself. I know he's in here somewhere, but he's catching a prick.
Well, he'll be in the Lancaster restaurant in about 10 minutes.
How do you know that?
Because I'm waiting on his table.
Oh.
Are you going to cause a scene?
Well, I might.
Well, just be careful.
Yeah, you too. And may I say you look lovely in that uniform.
Cheeky.
Yeah, well, that's me, isn't it?
You wish for this envelope to be passed on to Mr. Seedorf?
Well, it's not so much that I wish, but, yeah, it's fine.
Mr. Seedorf owns the hotel, but he's very rarely here, so may I suggest you pop a stamp in the top right-hand corner and post it to his London office?
No, it's important, I'll wait.
But it's not here.
Look, I'm here about the girl that was killed, Eva Krakovic, on the night of your wedding, I believe.
Hi, Martin. Then I suggest you get in touch with the police, because the man responsible was arrested and charged.
And executed. Only he didn't do it.
I want you to leave right now before I call the police.
And you're going to make sure Alex Seedorf gets my note?
No.
I'll tell you what. You call the old Bill, I'll order a pot of tea and wait here.
Sorry I'm late. Problem in reception.
Anything I should be aware of?
Later, perhaps.
Don't mind me.
No, Philip, this afternoon we talk about how we can help one another and nothing else. It's nothing, really. This is Beth. She's new.
Thank you. Oh, miss, could you change that for me? It's, a little dirty.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. She's nice.
She is.
Sharon, you're off. Be careful.
So, how's your bride, Martin? I'd hope she'd be here.
Anita's upset still. The hotel is not her favourite place.
Understandable.
Regrettable.
Thank you. Soft hands.
I keep them to myself.
Very good. Very good.
We may have a problem.
Mr. Seedorf. Sorry about bursting in on you like this, but I want a quick word about Raymond Kenyon.
Martin?
I've called the police.
Well, I thought you'd like to know that you didn't murder your waitress, which means someone else did. And I'd like to find out who. So I was hoping that you'd employ me.
And who are you?
Vincent Gallagher, private investigator.
Really? I didn't think you people existed.
Mr. Costello, didn't notice you there hiding behind your menu. What is it, another free lunch?
Mr. Gallagher, I'd prefer to leave this matter to the police, and I'd like you to leave the restaurant.
Not now, Gina.
But someone in this hotel saw something. Someone heard something. Someone paid for something. And someone in this hotel is protecting someone.
Gina, go away.
I thought you'd be interested, since it's your business.
I'll continue to put my trust in the British police.
Oh, they're good, yeah, they're very good. But I don't like a challenge. I do. So why don't you just think about it? Have a nice day.
Alright. Not really, though.
Can I help?
You know, they've decided to abandon lunch. Gina, did you hear anything that was said?
I can't say it. I can't deal with this anymore.
Yeah, deal with what?
I miss her so much.
Ava.
I miss her, just...
You should leave too.
Why? Gina!
Gina, why should I leave? Gina, please, I like it, Isa. Why should I leave?
Stay if you want to stay.
What are you telling me?
I said stay.
What are you telling me?
Are you stupid? Did you not see what was going on in the restaurant? Look, just steer clear of Martin Downing. He's got a thing for girls in uniform. You can really be charming with it. Some of us fall for it.
Who? Some of us fall for it. That's what she said.
Do you think something was going on between her and Martin Downing? I mean, was he serving her up?
Yeah, something, but I don't know what. I mean, they could be lovers, but going off lunchtime, Martin Downing's some kind of pimp. I was there for Costello to have a look at. I felt like I was part of the menu.
Maybe it was the MP that was missing a bit of
her. Who, the gay MP?
Or the bisexual MP, and things got out of hand.
So they covered up?
Yeah, in return for favours.
Have we got Gina's address here?
Yeah.
We're just going to have a check with her.
Vincent, the door's been forced.
My client would like to make a £20,000 donation to the widow of Raymond Kenyon. Although no way involved in the tragic events, my client realises how difficult the coming years will be for Mrs. Kenyon.
Who's your client?
Can't say.
Well, 20 grand's a lot of money.
It'd be paid in cash to you. How much expenses you deducted from that £20,000 would be your call. I'm sure a widow could get by on five.
Wow. You tell your governor to stick his 20 grand straight up his jacksie. If you weren't a kid, I'd eat you some more.
Big mistake.
Making sure you're awake, Vincent Gallagher. Police are on the way.
Deep breath.
What? Monroe, claustrophobic!
Oh.
Whose is the car?
The geezer's who's been following me.
Vince, what are we doing here?
She's dead. She's dead in my flat.
Generous.
Yeah.
What happened, mate?
Someone's stuck a needle in my leg and I backed out. I woke up and saw me. There was blood everywhere. Every fucking weapon. I don't know what happened. I haven't got a clue. Well, she's what I'm looking for.
Right.
John, just don't stand there. Don't just stand there.
So they will have found the body by now, yeah?
Yeah. Vince, you can't do this. You can't just run away.
It's already done.
Undo it.
What am I going to do? Just stand there and bend over?
No. You go to the police and you tell them everything you know.
You think they believe me?
You get a blood test, Vince. You find out what they pumped into you, and you do it before it disappears for good. What you don't do is rummage through a dead girl's flat. They could be here any minute.
They won't. But I took her ID.
You can't just run away from a body in a flat, Vince. You've got to go to the police.
Do you know whose name was on her phone as the last person she called?
You?
Yeah. Now, if they can pull strokes like that, and what other strokes are they going to pull to fit me up? I've got to find who killed Ava, who killed Kenyon, who killed Gina. Because if I get banged up, I'm going to be next.
You've got no chance of doing anything, mate.
Do you think not?
No, because within 24 hours, you won't even be able to show your face. You'll be all over the telly, and you'll be guilty! Mate, you've got to go to the police. You've got to go to the police.
Then who goes out the sea door?
I do.
Shit.
Well, I'm not that bad.
It's genius. That's all I've got. And here's a phone. I found it in the bedroom.
That's a busted camera.
But there's no memory card in it. But maybe that's nothing.
Thanks a lot, mate. Thank you.
Take it easy, eh?
I'm all right. I'm all right.
And then you thought better of it.
Yes. I want it noted that it's been over an hour since I asked for a blood test.
I'm arranging it.
Were you taking your time?
When you left your apartment, you ran directly to Gina's flat, correct?
Yes.
Why not to a doctor? For a blood test? Question too difficult.
I think I'm still a policeman. I just wanted to catch the killer myself.
Wasn't the first time you'd been to the flat, was it? You were seen leaving the flat last night. With Gina.
No.
We have a witness. Why did you kill her, Vincent?
I didn't.
But why was Gina killed? What happened between her leaving you, Beth, and Vincent finding her this morning?
Well, she knew something about Ava's murder, and I'm sure of that.
Oh, I'm sure you're right. Why ransack her flat unless they were looking for something?
But if she knew something or she had something, why did she go to the police at the time of the murder?
She was selling it.
Would she?
Yeah, she might.
Vincent found this in her flat. Right, they searched the flat. They find the camera, they step on it, they break it, but there's no memory card in it. Now, either they took it with them or it wasn't inside in the first place.
So she's selling the memory card. Then she's hidden it.
Hopefully.
She could hit it anywhere.
No, not anywhere, Jill. Yeah, somewhere. Somewhere safe, somewhere dry, somewhere where she can retrieve it.
There's a million somewheres.
No, Jillian, there's not. Okay, there's just one and we have to find it. She made three phone calls. Once to her mother, her number's in a notebook. One supposedly to Vincent, and the very first one in the evening to a mobile number.
Who's?
Beth. The other number. Go on.
Hey, it's me. Where are you?
Who's this?
Gina.
It doesn't sound like Gina.
I'm not messing about. Where are you?
Don't fuck me about. Who is this?
Martin Downing.
Are you sure?
Yeah, and he slept with Gina.
She said that?
No, not outright, but... Well, I'll bet my house something happened.
And we go to Cedar's Hotel. We find out about Gina and her work. And we think about the wedding. Yeah? What happens? What goes on? Who went there? Where was Gina? We think about Ava. The first murder. Where it happened. Here's something.
I am arresting you on suspicion of the murder of Gina Adamson. You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defense if you do not mention your question. Let you go in court. If you do say, you
did kill her. I didn't kill her.
Thank you very much. You can't be.
Good afternoon.
Hi. Would it be possible to speak to someone regarding the hire of a function room, please?
Is that private or corporate?
Private.
It's a wedding. Our wedding.
Oh, congratulations.
Can't wait.
Mr. Cassidy?
Yeah?
I'm Martin Downing, the general manager of the hotel.
All right.
You asked for this room specifically, and my staff and I were wondering why. And if there's anything else we can do to make your stay more comfortable.
This is the room where the murder was perpetrated, right? The waitress.
That's right.
Good. Only, murders are my thing. My hobby, not the executioner. The analysis of the places they occur. I've got a website. Would you like my card?
That won't be necessary.
You wouldn't happen to know the exact spot where the body was found, would you?
No, I don't. Well, I'll leave you to it then.
Okay.
Got some news for you, Vincent. There was nothing in your blood except alcohol. Any comment? Did she say no? Was that it?
It was fantastic. But we didn't get to see the bridal suite. Which was a shame, wasn't it, darling?
Always got to do.
It's being refurbished.
Well, why is it being refurbished?
We didn't ask.
Well, they're doing the whole floor or something.
No, it's on this floor. All the other suites are open for business.
Is it me? Does that not ring true? There was supposedly a murder committed in this room and all they've done is change a part of the carpet. This is a business. You know, they have ongoing repairs. Any refurbishment usually means the whole hotel or the whole floor. And then they reopen it with a fanfare.
So you're saying something might have happened in the bridal suite?
All I'm saying is it'd be good to know who was the last person to use it.
Mr. Downing, give me a fright.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry. I know I shouldn't be in here. I was just curious as to see what it looked like. In case... I'm sorry.
In case...
Yeah.
You have a boyfriend?
Yeah.
Lucky man. Now give me one good reason why I shouldn't fire you.
Because I'm really sorry.
It's not good enough. I'm serious.
Well, I need this job and I need the money.
Okay. Now you have my sympathy. Have dinner with me.
Are you married?
Anita won't mind. Besides, I'll be with a friend. I'd like you there to smile at her.
I don't think so.
I'll pay you.
No. I'd like to go.
It's only dinner. You'll be decorating.
I said I'd like to go. Ouch!
You said you needed the money.
You're hurting me.
Do you want me to call the police? You broke into a room, you silly bitch!
Come out of the bridal suite, you take a right and you're here, in this room.
Spending as little time as possible in the hotel corridors.
Well, if you did want to move a body from the bridal suite to another room, then yeah, this is the room you choose.
But if the bridal suite has been stripped bare, the only thing useful has been found or thrown out by now. It doesn't really help us, does it? Not really.
Not yet.
Get up there.
Lunch served at noon.
You Gallagher?
Yeah. They were talking about you at breakfast.
What did they say?
That you money? Back.
I had a eureka moment this morning. If something was so important to someone, like the memory card would be to Gina, she wouldn't hide it.
She'd keep it with her all the time.
I love doing that.
That's it.
Come back to the final picture. What's this?
What?
This.
I don't know. But they look like someone's just walked in.
It's the bride. That's a wedding dress.
So what you got?
A theory.
Oh, John, no.
Listen, Vince, give us a chance, will you? On the night of the big wedding, we're pretty sure that Ava Krakowicz was killed in the bridal suite and moved to a room next door. She's having an affair of sorts with the groom.
Martin Downing.
Ava and Gina thought it would be a good idea to seduce him in the bridal suite and take pictures.
So was it, Blenner?
Well, possibly.
And we've got the pictures.
The groom thinks with his general and goes for the seduction, only for the bride to come in and catch him at it. Maybe the bride strikes the first blow. And maybe Ava fights back and flies at the bride, only for the groom to wade in and finish her off. Now, what we are sure of is that between the two of them, they killed Ava. And because of the daughter's involvement, Alex Seedorf is sponsoring the cover-up, the chaos.
Right, well, why is Seedorf dealing with Martin Downing for cheating on his daughter?
Well, maybe he doesn't know.
Well, of course he knows.
Well, then maybe Anita's protecting him.
Or maybe he...
Maybe.
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 Maybe. Now's not the right time. Here. What do you think of that?
Well, what am I supposed to be
that
doing?
That there, Vince.
What?
That. We think it's the wedding dress.
No, we know it's the wedding dress. This picture was taken from a walk-in wardrobe, like a side room.
We need that dress, Vince. If we find Ava's blood on that dress, is it it places the bride at the murder scene.
And we've caught it. How are you going to get it?
We steal it. We go in with the cleaner.
And who's going in?
Chillion.
No, no way.
Vince.
No.
She wants to, Vince. She's been flagged at the hotel. Male cleaners aren't the norm. It's got to be Jill.
All right, but be careful.
That's my middle name.
What?
Careful. Oh, and we've tied the yellow ribbon round the old oak tree, by the way. Have you sang it?
Don't.
Very good.
There you go.
Colette's not well, so Gillian's helping me out today.
It's a lovely house.
As quick as you can, please, Maureen. If you need me, I'm in the conservatory.
Right. Stinks a bit.
It's her cigarettes and cooking. She burns everything. I reckon she does it on purpose. Mm. We do downstairs first. Stick to the routine, John said.
Right.
Have you lived here long?
Long enough to know I don't like it. Do you enjoy cleaning?
I enjoy my job. I don't particularly like cleaning at home, though. Maybe because I don't get paid for it.
Boyfriend?
Free and single at the minute.
And what are you looking forward to most?
The holidays. Can't wait. Are you all right? Is there anything I can get you, or...?
No, thank you.
My husband's just arrived home. If he asks, tell him I'm laying down.
Okay.
Nita!
I've left a muff in the bathroom! I'll get it. It's okay. Excuse me? Yeah?
Wouldn't it have been easier to steal money?
Sorry?
My wallet was on the dresser. You chose to take my wedding dress. Why?
I'm...
You're not a cleaner, are you?
I'm sorry? I need it. It's to help a friend.
Problem?
No problem. It's for your holidays.
Thank you.
You all right, mate?
Beth, what's going on?
We'd very much like to see Mr. Seedorf.
Who are you?
We have an invitation for yourself and Mr. Seedorf to visit Vincent Gallagher at Her Majesty's very own No Style Hotel. I'd like you to inform Mr. Seedorf that it would be in his and his daughter's best interest that he attends.
What's it got to do with Anita?
I think you know.
I'll pass the message on.
Oh, we could do that.
If you could just fetch him, please. I wouldn't bother with security.
You got a decision to make, Mr. Seedorf. And we know Ava was killed in the bridal suite. We also know Mr. Downing here was there when it happened.
This is nonsense.
We got proof. We got pictures.
Show me.
We've also got your daughter's bridal dress. Now, when they examined the dress, they found traces of Ava's blood on it. Which means your daughter was there when she was murdered. But you already knew that, right?
She won't, boy.
Do you know what, darling? I think I do. Thank you. I'll keep it till later, yeah? Thanks.
Mr. Gallagher, if you have stolen anything that belongs to my daughter, I strongly suggest that you return it.
I haven't stolen anything as such. It's more like she wanted us to have it. She's had enough. She wants an end to it.
I'll give her a call.
You'll stay where you are.
It's true.
I can check it.
My daughter is guilty of nothing except loving the wrong men. A shit. You try to protect your children. But as they grow older, it becomes more difficult. You have limited control. How much?
I need the truth.
I only know what my daughter wants me to believe. That she found her husband with the waitress. That she lost control and struck out. The girl was bleeding and threatened to parade herself in front of my guests. So Anita attacked again. The girl fell to the floor, Anita fled.
Thinking she killed her, yeah. Did you see the body?
No.
Ava died of internal bleeding. It's quite possible she fell to the floor unconscious. But then someone kicked the shit out of her. Because he got caught with another girl, or because his world had just fallen apart, so he thought he'd pick on someone else. Why not a woman?
Alex, this is one man.
I need a confession.
This is one man talking bollocks.
I need the killer to come forward and confess to the murder of Gina and Ava.
For God's sake, you are in no position to make any demands.
I want you to clear my name. No one will mention your daughter's involvement. Mind you, I think she's suffered enough, don't you? That's it.
Martin, what do you have to say?
It's nonsense. He's bullshitting. Let me see the pictures. Let me see the dress.
No.
Because they don't exist. Do you think we're stupid?
You know they exist. Yeah, I want an answer.
Martin.
He's lying. I swear to God, she was dead when she hit the floor. Anita killed her. We need to protect Anita.
Agreed.
Thank you.
Somebody needs to step forward to protect my daughter. Your wife. You'll be that somebody, Martin. What do you say? I don't think you have a choice.
Yes or no?
Yes.
We have a deal, Mr. Gallagher.
Good. Thank you very much.
What is it?
That's my iPod. I take it everywhere.